I am Pharaoh, King of Egypt. The reason I called this press conference is to read a brief statement about the future of our country. Then, I will take a few questions from reporters. As you know, about 7 years ago, I had a dream in which I prophesied 7 years of ample rainfall and bumper crops for Egypt's farmers, followed by 7 years of record-breaking drought and famine. As you also know, these last 7 years of prosperity have surpassed even my expectations. But the time for rejoicing has passed. As you know, the famine has begun right on schedule. So, I hereby declare a state of emergency, during which my Prime Minister Joseph, son of Jacob, who was in charge of collecting and storing the surplus grain from the bumper crops, will now administer the sale of grain during the coming famine. Joseph will have the power of life and death over anyone who hoards or steals grain during the 7 year famine. And may the God who prophesied the famine through me preserve the land of Egypt during the coming hard times.
Your Majesty, Joseph is a foreigner. Would an Egyptian citizen be a wiser choice for the office of Prime Minister at such a momentous time in Egyptian history?
Actually, you have your facts wrong. Joseph is a citizen.
But I was led to believe that Joseph was a Hebrew from the land of Canaan.
He is both of those. But I personally declared Joseph to be an official citizen of Egypt 7 years ago, after he interpreted my dream which predicted this famine. Even if Joseph wasn't a citizen by declaration, he would be a citizen by marriage, as he married the daughter of an Egyptian priest.
But in addition to being a foreigner, Joseph is also a convicted felon.
You need to get your facts straight. While it is true that Joseph spent several years in jail, he was exonerated of all charges 7 years ago, after a thorough investigation.
But the charges against him were brought by the captain of the palace guard. Are you saying that he lied?
I'm saying that the captain of the palace guard was deceived. It turns out that his wife was pursuing a romantic relationship with Joseph while Joseph worked on her household staff. But when Joseph rejected her advances, she sought revenge by filing false rape charges against Joseph. He's an innocent man.
So, you're not bothered by the fact that your prime minister is not a native Egyptian?
During the past 7 years as my prime minister, Joseph has shown himself to be loyal and honest and a capable leader. What difference does it make what country he was born in?
It might make a difference if Joseph shows preference to his own countrymen when they come to Egypt to buy grain from us.
Is it true that Joseph's brothers came to Egypt recently to buy grain for their families?
Yes, but I can assure you that he didn't show them any preferences. Joseph threw one of his brothers in jail and sent the others home.
Why would he do that?
When Joseph was living in the land of Canaan, his brothers sold him into slavery. His slaveholders sold him into slavery here in Egypt.
Why would his brothers treat him with such contempt?
As many of you know, Joseph has inherited his father's gift of prophecy. His gift of prophecy is even more profound than my own. 7 years ago, Joseph was the only person in the entire land of Egypt who could interpret my own dream predicting the famine. But what we Egyptians see as a valuable gift from God, Joseph's brother saw as a threat. You see, Joseph was not the firstborn son to his father Jacob. But inheriting the gift of prophecy meant he would supplant his older brothers as their father's favorite son. It was jealousy that caused them to sell Joseph into slavery.
Now that Joseph is prime minister, do you think he'll declare war on his brothers and have them all killed?
Well, I would seek revenge, if I were him, but Joseph's high moral character will undoubtedly prevail.
The brothers will undoubtedly return here to get their brother out of jail. What do you think Joseph will do to them?
Joseph only held his brother hostage in order to get his father and the rest of his family to come to Egypt. I think that, once Joseph sees his parents again, he'll forget all about revenge and focus on reconciliation. That's the kind of person Joseph is, and that's why I named him Prime Minister. And now, may the God of Joseph and his father Jacob bless the nation of Egypt.
Based on a play by Bob Snook, conditions for use. Do not sell any part of this script, even if you rewrite it. Pay no royalties, even if you make money from the performance. You may reproduce and distribute this freely, but all copies must contain this statement.